Welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School Channel. Myself Priscilla Asade. I am going to teach you English grammar of grade 4. So students, do you remember what we have learned till now? Yes, we have finished with our tense. So right from lesson number 16 to lesson number 20, we have finished tense. So we'll just have a recap what we have learned. So we have finished with simple present, simple past, simple future and plus present continuous tense also. So in this, what we have learned students, first in simple present, what we have to use? Yes, we have to use is, are, am plus with the original form of verb. And in simple present tense, what we are going to do? We are going to add s to the original form of the verb. This was simple present. Okay, so all together what I have done, I have divided house. You just see how I have divided and I have made a chart. Now for simple past, if it is simple past tense, then what we are going to use? Yes, we are going to use was, were plus original form of verb. And if we want to make the past tense form, if we want to make it in simple past, so what we are going to use? We are going to use in simple past tense form of the verbs. How here we have added s to the verb, so here we can add ed, or we can use the past tense form of verb, which I told you that was on the chart in on the page 53 and 54. Now if it is simple future, so what are the words we are going to use? Yes, we are going to use will be and shall be plus the original form of verb. OFV is what students? That is original form of verb. Okay, now if in simple present tense we have to, if we want to make the negative sentences in simple present, so what we are going to do? If it is in singular, we are going to use does not. In this, if you see, not is very important. If the subject is singular, so we are going to use does not. If the subject is in plural, we are going to use do not. Not is very important in negative sentences. Okay, now if it is in simple past, so what is the word? Yes, see the difference here, does not is there. So if it is in simple past while making negative sentence, so what is the word used? Did not plus the original form of verb. Here also we are going to use the original form of verb. Okay, so here what is the word? Did not. In present tense we are going to use does not, and in simple past we are going to use did not. Okay, understood? Now in future tense, so what we are going to use? Will not. What we are going to use? Will not plus original form of verb. Here we can see not is very important for the negative sentences when we are making it in simple present, simple past or simple future. Again, what we have learned students? Yes, questions. If you want to make the questions in simple present tense, so if it is singular, subject is singular, so what was the rule? Does plus subject plus original form of verb. Again, if it is plural, then do plus subject plus original form of verb. This was simple present tense when we are making questions in simple present tense. So this is the rule. Now simple past, so what is the rule? Did plus subject plus original form of verb. And if it is in simple future, so will plus subject plus original form of verb. Understood students till here what we have learned right from the lesson number 16 to 20? And if you see, one lesson was there in between, that is after simple present tense. Okay, that was lesson number 18, present continuous tense. In that, what we have learned students? Yes, what we have learned, that in present continuous tense is, are, am, as it is in present tense. Okay, present continuous tense, so we are going to use of the same words is, are, am plus ing form of the verb. So whenever any verb is having ing, so you have to understand that that sentence is a present continuous tense. So this was all about the recap which we have learned right from lesson number 16 to lesson number 20. So do you know students what is the next lesson? Are you excited to learn? Now here we have finished with all our tense. Our next lesson is lesson number 1. You can open your Fun with Grammar book, lesson number 21, that is adverbs. Just open and keep. When I tell you that time only, you just look in your book. Now you can look on the screen. Ready, students? Okay. So our today's lesson number is lesson number 21. That is adverbs. Now, what do you mean by adverbs? Today we are going to learn all about adverbs. Ready, students? Okay. So what is adverbs? Yes, adverbs add meaning to a verb, adjective, and again adverb. Okay, again I'll repeat. This is the definition of adverb. What is that? Adverbs add meaning to a verb, adjective, and adverb itself. Now, how it is that we will see afterwards, okay? When we start with the lesson from the book. Now, in adverbs, still what we are going to learn? How many kinds of adverbs are there? So, we are going to learn today different kinds of adverbs, okay? So, in today's lesson, there are four kinds of adverbs. First is adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place, and last, adverb of frequency. Understood? So these are the four kinds of adverbs that we are going to learn today. How many kinds of adverbs are there, students? Four: adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place, adverb of frequency. Okay, I'll just introduce what are all these. Okay, what is adverb of manner? Now, adverb of manner means it tells us how an action is done. Okay, next is adverb of time, when or what time action has been done. Okay, how an action is done, when or what time the action has been done. An action takes place where action took place, and frequency means how many times the action, how much, if you say how often certain actions Again, I'll repeat. Now, the four kinds of adverb are adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place, adverb of frequency. Now, adverb of manner, it shows how an action is done. Means, what is the manner? Okay. Next, adverb of time, when or what time action has been done or it has took place. Adverb of place, where, the place where the action took place. And the fourth is adverb of frequency, how often certain actions are done. As the lesson is big, so students, we are going to see only two things in this part one. Okay, in the next, we will see, in the next session we will see adverb of place and adverb of frequency. So these are the things which we are going to learn today. So ready, students? I'll just open Fun with Grammar book, page number 68. So now we are on the page number 68, Fun with Grammar book, lesson number 21, adverbs. Okay, so what is the definition, students? Here make it a star, right? So that you can learn this definition. So adverbs add meaning to a verb, adjective or an adverb. Now how it does? Okay, so we'll see one example so that you will come to know how the definition works. Now first example. Examples first. She sang sweetly. What is the example over here? She sang sweetly. What is the verb over here? Yes, sang is a verb and sweetly is a adverb. So sweetly is an adverb. What is this? Sweetly is an adverb that adds meaning to the verb sang. Understood, students? Okay. Again, I'll see. First, we'll see adverbs add meaning to a verb. The first example, she sang sweetly. What is the verb over here? Sang. And adverb is sweetly. So, sweetly is an adverb that adds meaning to the verb sang. Understood? So, how she sang? She sang sweetly. Understood with the first one? Next. Adverb add meanings to an adjective. How now? She is a very intelligent person. Again, I'll repeat my sentence. She is a very intelligent person. Now, can you tell me, students, what is adjective in this sentence? Very good. Adjective is intelligent. What is adjective? Do you remember? We have learned in lesson in adjective lesson. Adjective adds, describes about noun. So how is that person? Intelligent. So intelligent is adjective. Okay. Now how is she? Very intelligent. So very is an adverb which adds meaning to the adjective. So very is an adverb. Very is an adverb. Okay. That adds meaning to the adjective intelligent. Understood, student? Adverbs add meaning to an adjective. How the adverbs add meaning to the adjective? Again, I'll repeat. She is a very intelligent person. So, what is adjective in this sentence, students? Intelligent. So, very is an adverb that adds meaning to the adjective intelligent. Okay? Here we have seen this is verb. This is adverb. Next, third is what? Adverbs add meaning to an adverb. How? What is this definition again? Adverbs add meaning to the adverb itself. How now? She sings very sweetly on stage. Now, here if you see, sweetly is what, students? Very good. It is adverb. And very is also adverb. So here we will see the word very is an adverb that adds meaning to another adverb, that is sweetly. And in this way we have finished with our definition, that is adverbs add meaning to a verb, to an adjective and to an adverb. I hope that you have understood till here. Okay. Now next what we are going to see, students? Yes, we are going to see the different kinds of adverb. So how many kinds of adverb just now introduced you? There are four kinds of adverbs, that is adverb of manner, adverb of time, adverb of place and adverb of frequency. In that only two kinds we are going to see. The first one is adverbs of manner. Write here first if you want. Okay. Kinds of adverbs. There are different kinds of adverbs that are used for different purposes. Okay. What is the first one? Adverbs of manner. Now, adverbs of manner means what? Adverb of manner tells us how an action is done. Can you see here? Okay. So, just underline that how. Anyhow, it is in bold. What you'll do in your book, students? Take pencil in your hand, okay, and write, underline there. So adverbs of manner tells us how an action is done. Now we'll see example, then you'll come to know. Okay, the old man walked. how he walked slowly. So the manner of walking, how he walked, that is slowly. So slowly is an adverb of manner. And what is the verb over here? Yes, walked. She danced gracefully. Okay, so gracefully is an adverb of manner. She ran quickly. How he ran? Yes, quickly. So this is adverb of manner. Adverb. So in third example, he ran quickly. How he ran? Yes, he ran quickly. The way of his running was, he ran very quickly. Now here, if you see students, three words, slowly, gracefully and quickly. What it describes? How the certain actions have been done. So these are called the adverbs of manner. You can see here, slowly, gracefully and quickly describe how certain actions are done. Okay, so these words are called adverbs of manner or how adverbs. One more name is being given to this, adverbs of manner or how adverbs. Got it? Okay, now here they have given some more information about that. Most adverbs of manner end in ly. Can you see here ly? Ly, ly, ly. Okay, to all these words, what has been added? Ly. Examples, softly, quickly, loudly. Sometimes the spellings have to be altered before adding ly. For example, altered means we have to change it. How? We will just see. So what we are learning? Adverbs of manner. Okay, so they have told that all the words end with ly, but there are some spellings which have to be altered before adding ly. For example, simple, we are not going to add ly over here. Okay, so what we are going to do? We are going to cut this e and then we are going to add y. Next is merrily. So what is the spelling? Merry, merrily. What is the spelling? We will cut y and then we are going to add I plus ly. Angry, same. Y you'll cut, you'll add I, L, Y. And for happy also, we are going to cut Y and then we are going to add I, L, Y. So whenever a word ends with Y. So what we are going to do, how we are going to make it adverb? By adding ly. Done till here, students? Understood? Okay. Now, position of adverbs of manner. Where the position should be of these adverbs of manner. Ready? Okay. So adverbs of manner are placed after the verbs they describe. Again, I'll repeat, students. Adverbs of manner are placed when? After. Underline that after. After the verbs they describe. Example, Adi sang sweetly. Now Adi sang the song. Okay, how he sang? Sweetly. So can you see, sang is verb and adverb is sweetly. Okay, so this adverb has been placed after the verb. So what is the position of the adverb of manner in a sentence? It will come after the verb. Now we'll come to next page. Here they have given some note. Can you see here in this? Here. Okay. Some adverbs of manners do not end in ly. They are fast, well, hard. This word you have to keep in mind. Next. Come to page number 69. Now here in this one block they have given something. Just we will see what is there. Difference between an adverb and an adjective. We have learned about adjective. Okay, adjective tells us more about nouns and adverbs tells about more about a verb, adverb and an adjective, but never a noun. Just underline what I have underlined. Again I'll repeat, what is the difference between an adverb and an adjective? Adjective is what? Adjective tells more about noun and adverb tells us more about a verb, adverb or an adjective, but it never tells us about a noun. And here example they have given, she sang in a sweet voice. So what is the noun over here? Noise. How she sang? Very sweetly. Sweet. So adjective is sweet. And here we'll see the difference. She sang sweetly. And see the position of the adverb. It has come after the verb. She sang sweetly. Can you see the difference? Okay. Understood? So it was just a thing that you have to just keep in your mind. Now we are going to solve the examples. Ready, students? Example A, exercise A, what is the instruction given over here? Circle the adverbs of manner. What they have told? We have to circle the adverbs of manner in the sentences and you have to underline the verbs they are added to. To which verb they are added. Understood? We have to circle the adverbs of manner and we have to just underline the verb. So what we will do? We will first find out the verb and we will underline that. And then which adverb of manner has been added, that we will circle it. Ready? First, the girl sang melodiously. I hope that you are having pencil along with you and you have to do with me. If you have understood everything, you can solve. Still, I'll explain you again. The girl sang melodiously. Okay? So, how she sang melodiously? So, I'm going to... Next, the student spoke politely. Now, here in this example, if you'll see how the student spoke. Yes, what is the verb over here? Spoke. So, I'm going to underline spoke. And how they spoke? Politely. And the other way of recognizing adverb of manner is... It ends with ly. Okay. Now third, Jyoti ran fast. Ran is verb. And I have told you that always an adverb of manner will never end with ly. So this is fast, adverb of manner. Next, she smiled shyly. So smiled is verb and shyly is a adverb of manner. Next, the child cried bitterly. Cried is action. How she cried? Bitterly. So bitterly is adverb of manner. You should drive. Drive. How?
I'll come to the seventh example. India play well. So how India play? Play is verb. And well is